My name is Deron Chavis, urban farmer, community activist, and food justice advocate. Join me and my comrades as we talk resiliency, community, social justice, and why Black space matters.
We're here at the amazing Institute for Contemporary Art and the Resiliency Garden exhibit, and I'm here chopping it up with my good friend, Silly Genius.
How you doing?
I want to give you an opportunity to tell the people who is Silly Genius, what is All City Art Club. Go ahead and give the people a little bit of a dose of your resume.
I am a local, just artist, man. I do a lot, just be it photography or video or painting. I am the founder of All City Art Club, kind of like a grassroots art initiative to bring more public art to kind of like overlooked, forgotten parts of the city. So most of our work is centered in Southside, but just trying to branch out and just paint wherever we can, where there isn't a presence of public art already.
Okay, so you're creative. So what inspired you to get into this work?
I mean, I've been making art all my life, so it's always been a thing that I wanted to do. But it kind of, it met with public art when the city kind of started to embrace street art more. So it would just be, the mural festivals and the street art festival, but like they would only be focused in kind of like the more touristy, like polished parts of town. Right. And I lived on the South Side and I would just pass like these massive walls and abandoned buildings every day. Like, yo, this is a perfect opportunity to like further this, new street art thing that the city's trying to get into, but they just didn't. So I just kind of took it upon myself. Right. And got up with some homies and like, yo, this is what we're gonna do. All right. And All City Art Club was born.
So tell us a little bit about what that was like for you as an artist, kind of entering into the social justice space and like merging your artwork with highlighting Black narratives.
It was kind of weird at first, because I never saw myself as an activist or even imagined that I would end up in those spaces. Like with my art, it just was kind of a thing, like somebody suggested you should try for this, and I'm like, okay, I'll do it. And right. I never gave it a second thought. And then I got selected and started to see a little bit more about how my like journey or path intersected with other people's journeys, and kind of seeing, like realizing like, yo, I have more power than I initially thought I did. And just trying to figure out ways, like how can I use like art and my talents and just further like help everyone else, but also like further myself. Like it's right. it's a mutually beneficial kind of thing. We all help each other. We further each other's goals.
Anybody that's come through this space, they're seeing you every day, every time they come through. Tell us a little bit about the collaboration and the work that you all did here at the Resiliency Garden at the ICA.
So we painted this this wall behind us and the words on the ground, and we painted some of the wood that was used to create the raised garden beds. I have a special place in my heart for graffiti.
Right.
And I see the validity of it as an art form, whereas some people just, it's just vandalism or whatever, but it's like a medium of art that existed since the beginning of time. Like people used to paint on cave walls, and now we're painting, we're painting graffiti on the side of buildings, but it's all the same thing. Like, how can I get a message across in a way that words couldn't, you know what I mean? And so being able to bring that to this space, I remember when this used to be like the Hess.
Right.
You know what I mean? Like, as sketchy as that gas station used to be, it was like, if I say it would meet me at the Hess, you knew exactly what I was talking about. It was like, it was a part of the scene.
Certainly.
For it to be just gone now, and it's just a parking lot. It's like, yo, how can this become useful? So when you came with the idea of like, yo, we're gonna put like this garden installation there, like, can you put some art on it? It's like, yo, of course. You know what I mean? Like, yo, this is a space where like you can feel good and feel welcome and feel like invited, and like that you just want to come out here and just like, eat your lunch and chill. Like, just I like that kind of energy, and like I was just jumped at the chance to like add something to that.
How do you interpret when you hear someone say Black space matters?
We've seen so many like spaces and venues that were like very important to the scene or the culture just kind of like come and go. For me, Black Space Matters is like us having a space that we own, operate, control, whatever, where we're not like, it can't be snatched away by somebody saying like, this no longer valuable. You know, like Richmond nightlife. Like, yeah, we're not gonna play no hip hop here. It's like, you know what I mean?
Right. Or so certain dress code, you know, you only can wear certain things, so it's already implied that this
is a certain. So for me, Black Space Matters is like, yo, is this a space where no matter what our ideas, our thoughts, our culture, our gathering, whatever, like, it's safe here. That's what Black Space Matters means to me.
And I think about, you know, Marcus Davis, Peter Circle, right? Where these ideas of race, these ideas of white supremacy, these ideas of revolution, right, have all kind of like converged, right? How do you see like the way that art has taken center stage, right? And that in this type of transformation of Richmond over the last 8 months?
For me, like I've been in Richmond since 2004 maybe, and never once had I thought to step on that circle, like never until this summer. And now to see it become this kind of like gathering space, like for everybody, for all walks of life, this is like a testament to like the power of art as a way to bring everybody to like the same, at least bring them to the conversation, you know what I mean? And just seeing that ripple effect of people being more willing to pay attention to what the artists are saying. And then, like somebody coming to me about like my opinion on something, I could just, you should listen to this activist, you know what I mean? Like,
right.
I'm just painting the things that they are like actually saying.
You're like a translator.
Yeah.
I remember us talking about how you wanted to create a space for that type of thing, you know, to happen for other artists. You want to talk a little bit about that effort and that work?
You know, you're not going to school for like street art, like how do I get up or whatever. Like you just, that's one of those things you're gonna have to take some kind of risk to get into. And like me being like Black already adds a couple more notches of like, you know, play Grand Theft Auto where like you get the stars and it's a little bit more dangerous. Like I'm already starting out with like two stars just because, like, you know what I mean? Like me lurking around at night, committing like acts of, you know what I'm saying, vandalism. So creating a space where people can like earn their stripes and, you know what I'm saying, just steel sharpen steel, be around other artists. And like street art, it's like, it's an ephemeral kind of thing. It doesn't last forever.
Right.
So there's always going to be that new. Somebody's going to put a new kind of spin on it or do something new and just like creating this environment where people can safely get those ideas out.
Yeah. So it's like, even though it's illegal, we need this.
Yeah.
This is, and so why does it become like, I'll risk catching this charge to express myself. Like, why is that?
Like, if I wanted to paint the side of this building, it's illegal. But if I want to put a billboard up, oh, yo, come on. You know what I'm saying? All comers welcome. You know what I mean? Like, that barrier of entry to, like, saying anything publicly is based on, like, monetary, like, whatever. You can say whatever you want to as long as you got some money. You know what I'm saying? But, like, they can walk into Lowe's and buy a can of paint. You know what I'm saying? Just and get that message out there.
Right.
And, you know what I mean? That's what it means to me. I need to get this message out. And it shouldn't be dependent on my financial status to say these things.
What has been, I guess, like some of the reflections on participating in this and just being a part of this particular act of guerrilla art, I guess, so to speak?
Seeing people embrace the space as like, oh, this is ours. You know what I mean? Like before it was just a parking lot. Like. I don't even own a car. Like, you know what I mean? So like, what purpose does the parking lot have to me? You know what I mean? But a park, like a garden, like, you know what I'm saying? I can enjoy it for, you know what I'm saying, what it is. So like, just seeing that, like seeing people stop, you know what I'm saying? That's the head turner, like, oh man, this is a garden. I'm gonna take a walk through. I'm gonna stop, I'm gonna hang out. I'm gonna, you know what I'm saying? Or just, I'm gonna get involved now. Like I always wanted to get into gardening or I wanted to, whatever is drawing people to it in a way that it didn't before. It was just pavement. Right. So.
What's on the horizon for 2021?
Just more of what I was doing for 2020. Just more opportunities to get up, to say some things, more art shows, more murals, engaging with the community, finding opportunities for other artists to do their thing. Ain't no fun if the homies can't have none. You know what I mean? Like, so. So more, just more, you know what I'm saying, stuff. More, we got another project around the way, doing the Swansboro thing, the underpass.
Nice.
So we'll be doing that this year. Just more art, more whatever we can do, man. Just more creativity, more everything.
Thank you for coming through, man.
Thank you for having me.
This is Deron Chavis with Black Space Matters. We're chopping it up with my homie, Silly Genius. Y'all tune in next week for this work that we call Black Space Matters. Mm-hmm.